In our last video, we talked about the popular misconception that brass height is somehow an indication of hull strength. While it's true that aside from brass height, most shotshell hulls actually look quite similar, the fact is that not all hulls are created equal. This week we're going to take a look at what makes a quality hull for reloading, including body construction, base wall material, and hull wall shape. This should help get you started on the road to selecting the best hulls available in your area, as well as ensuring you understand the limitations and risks of each. Using a cutting wheel, I've made some simple cross-sections of the hulls we'll be looking at. Although crude, they do a pretty decent job of showing you what's inside. Although there are literally hundreds of hulls out there, the ones I've chosen for this demonstration include a Winchester AA+, Winchester AA, Winchester Universal, and Federal Field and Range. The first thing we're going to talk about is hull body construction. This is, arguably, the most important factor in determining a hull's suitability for reloading. There are two basic types of hull bodies, including one-piece and two-piece. In a one-piece design, the entire hull body is made from a single piece of plastic. This design is prized by reloaders since the internal base of the hull is actually molded from the hull body itself, making it extremely durable and strong. Here we have a Winchester AA+ branded compression-formed plastic hull featuring one-piece construction. Note how everything from the hull walls to the base and even the primer pocket are made from one solid piece of plastic. The superior strength of this design allows these hulls to be reloaded many, many times. In a two-piece design, the hull body is made from a plastic casing with a separate, bonded base wad, which is usually glued into place. Although not as durable as the one-piece design, the two-piece can still be a reliable and useful hull for reloading so long as you take the time to inspect them carefully first. Here we see a Winchester Universal branded polyform plastic hull with a plastic base wad. Note how the base wad is clearly made from a separate piece of plastic. This hull is easy to spot since the base wad is a different color. However, that's not always the case. To illustrate just how tricky these can be, take a look at this Winchester AA branded HS plastic hull with a plastic base wad. It's very hard to see, and even harder to film, but if you look carefully, you'll see the seam where the base wad meets the hull wall. Tricky stuff. If you're reloading two-piece hulls, remember to inspect the internal base wad closely every time you load them. If the base wad is starting to separate from the hull wall, or it looks deformed or damaged in any way, throw it out. Although I've never experienced it or even met someone who has, the fact is that damaged base wads can theoretically become separated from the hull and wind up lodged in your gun barrel. I do want to stress here though, that although one-piece hulls are definitely the most durable, the two-piece variety are still very reliable and can be reloaded many times as well. I regularly reload and shoot two-piece hulls and certainly would never discourage anyone from doing the same thing, so long as you exercise some common sense. Alright, with hull bodies covered, let's move on to base wad materials. As we've already discussed, the base wad is the internal portion of the bottom of a shotshell hull. It's responsible for retaining the primer and holding the powder charge, so it's obviously a pretty important component. Just as hulls can be made from different materials, so too can base wads. Although plastic remains by far the most popular, there are also paper and even metal base wads out there. I've never actually encountered a metal base wad before personally, so for me, plastic is the preferred choice. Plastic is waterproof, bonds better to the hull wall, and doesn't fray or burn the way that paper can. This Winchester Universal branded polyform plastic hull has a bright white plastic base wad. Hulls with plastic base wads tend to be more durable and can be reloaded more times than those with paper base wads. Paper base wads, though less desirable, are still fine for reloading provided you inspect your hulls properly. Here we have a Federal Field and Range branded plastic hull with a paper base wad. The cross-section base wad appears shiny like plastic as a result of the cutting wheel that I used to divide it, but trust me, it's paper. It's important to remember that paper base wads are not waterproof, meaning if you pick these up off the ground, they could be soggy. Likewise, paper base wads are more likely to separate from their plastic hulls, making it critical that you inspect these before reloading them every time. Although I do often reload these, I like to make it a practice to discard them after maybe 3 to 4 reloads, just in case as a precautionary measure. With base wad materials out of the way, next it's time to take a look at hull wall shape. This is probably the single most overlooked aspect of hull selection, which is a shame because it probably has the greatest impact on accuracy and consistency. Hull wall shape refers to the angle and internal diameter of the hull walls, particularly where they meet the base. There are two types of hull wall shape, straight-walled and tapered. What makes this so important is that the diameter of gas seals on modern wads can vary. Using the wrong wad can impact pressure, velocity, and accuracy. In a straight-walled hull, the internal diameter of the hull is virtually the same from top to bottom. As the name implies, the walls are essentially completely straight. As you can see on this Federal Field & Range branded plastic hull, the diameter of the hull is nearly identical all the way down. As a result, this hull will work best with wads that are designed for straight-walled cases. If a wad made for a tapered case is used by mistake, the base may not completely cover the powder charge, resulting in greatly reduced velocity, power, and accuracy. In a tapered hull, the internal diameter of the hull decreases towards the bottom. In a one-piece design, this will be molded right into the plastic. In a two-piece design, the taper generally starts inside the base wad. As you can see on this Winchester AA branded HS plastic hull, the walls narrow considerably towards the bottom. When using tapered hulls, optimum results are obtained by using wads designed specifically for tapered walls. If a wad made for a straight-walled case is used by mistake, the base or support legs of that wad may become crushed or deformed, raising the pressure and affecting accuracy. Likewise, straight-wall wads can scrape against the seams of the plastic base wad, causing them to separate or become jammed. To summarize, when choosing hulls for reloading, you want to look for the best quality materials you can find in your area. Whenever possible, stick to one-piece hulls with a plastic base wad. This is especially true when you're working with high-pressure loads like buckshot or slugs. If you don't have access to one-piece hulls, go with a two-piece design that incorporates a plastic base wad. Whatever body style you do choose, make sure you're using a hull wall shape that's suited to the wads you plan to work with. And finally, be picky. If a hull is starting to show its age, the base wad looks iffy, or the mouth just won't hold a crimp anymore, throw it out. Body construction, base wad material, and hull shape all play important roles in determining a hull's suitability for reloading, as well as its accuracy and safety. Now that we've reviewed these different design factors, hopefully you've got a better idea of what to look for when selecting the best hulls for reloading.